Hi there! In the previous video, we explored the user interface in Sawla Animate. In this video, we'll learn to create a custom workspace. To create a custom workspace, it will arrange panes and customize keyboard shortcuts. Sawla Animate has 8 panes in total, which are possible to be hidden or revealed. They're also movable and scalable. To show or hide panes, click the View menu. A tick mark next to a label means that the pane is active. Another way to hide a pane is click the Close button in the top right corner. Next to the Close button is a Float button. This button allows you to undock a pane and move it wherever you want. You can also simply click and drag the title bar of a pane to undock it. If you don't want to leave the pane floating, you can dock it in a drop zone or add it to a group. A drop zone is either the left, bottom, right, or top sides of the window where you can dock panes. When two panes or more share the same drop zone, they are grouped. In a group, you can drag the pane left or right by its type to reorder it. If you want to remove a pane from a group, drag it outside the group. Besides toggling, moving, docking, and grouping panes, you can resize panes to the dimensions you want. By doing so, you can enlarge a canvas or a certain pane when you need, and create a more efficient and focused working environment. Remember that Sawla Animate saves the project settings when you close a project. It will apply those settings the next time you open the application. So that's how you arrange panes. For the remaining part of this video, we'll learn to customize keyboard shortcuts. To customize shortcuts, click the Edit menu and select Preferences. Then open the Shortcuts tab. As you can see, all major commands are grouped functionally. Click this triangle to show the commands. Any currently used shortcuts are displayed in the Shortcut column. To assign a new shortcut, select a command. Then, click inside the new shortcut box and press the combination of keys you want. If the combination is already in use, the current used by box will show the commands associated with it. If not, the box shows nothing. Now click the Assign button to assign the new shortcut, and click Apply to submit changes. Along with assigning new shortcuts, you can reassign an already used shortcut to a new command. For example, the shortcut Ctrl+A is already used by the silicone command. You can reassign it to the Convert to Symbol command. But by doing so, you won't be able to silicone by pressing Ctrl+A anymore. So be careful when reassigning shortcuts. If you go wrong, click the Restore Defaults button to go back to the original settings. Occasionally, you may want to remove a shortcut. Just select a command and click the Remove button. That's how we create a custom workspace to your liking. Hope this helps.